Surah Kahf is one of the surah which Prophet Muhammad advised us to read on every Friday. And it's very important against the protection against the Dajjal, against Shaitan. It's beautiful, there's so many good teachings there. In the name of Allah, the gracious, the merciful. All praises for Allah, who sent down upon his slave the book and did not make in it any crookedness. No defect there in this book, the Quran. Rightly directing that he might give warning of severe punishment from him and give good news to the believers who do good, that they shall have a goodly reward. Staying in it in paradise forever. And warn those who say Allah has taken a son. They have no knowledge of it, nor had their forefathers. A grievous word is it, is that comes out from their mouths. They speak nothing but a lie. Then maybe you will kill yourself with grief, sorrowing after them, if they do not believe in this announcement, the Quran. Surely we have made weather, whatever is on the earth, an establishment for it, and adornment for it, as a beauty for it, so that we may try them, which of them is best in the works. And most surely we will make what is on it bare ground without herbage. Or do you think that the fellows of the cave and the inscriptions were of our wonderful science? When the young men seek refuge in the cave, they said, "Our Lord, grant us mercy from you and provide us for a right way in our affair, right course in our affair." So we prevented them from hearing in the cave for a number of years. Then we raised them up that we might know which of the two parties was best able to compute the time for which they remained. We relate to you their story with the truth. Surely they were young men who believed in their Lord, and we increased them in guidance. And we strengthened them, their hearts, with patience, and they stood up and said, "Our Lord is the Lord of the heavens and the earth. We will be by no means call upon any God beside him, or then indeed we should have said an extravagant thing." These our people have taken gods beside him, beside Allah. Why do they not produce any clear authority in their support? Who is then more unjust than he who forges a lie against Allah? And when you forsake them and what they worship beside Allah, betake yourself for refuge to the cave. Your Lord will extend to you largely of his mercy and provide for you a profitable course in your affair. And you might see the sun when it rose decline from their cave towards the right hand, and when it sets, leave them behind on the left, while they were in a wide space thereof. This is one of the signs of Allah. Whomsoever Allah guides, he is the rightly guided one. And whomsoever he causes to misguide, you shall not find for him any friend to lead him aright. So these people were young people, and they want not to worship the idols, and their people wanted to kill them if they don't worship the idols. So they pray to Allah to save their iman, to save their faith. So they take refuge in the cave, and Allah put them sleep. And they sleep for more than 300 years. How many years? More than 300 years they slept. So all the people who wanted to force them to become disbelievers already dead. New generation came in, but they were still intact. And how Allah make them alive and to let them sleep for more than 300 years, it's a miracle. And what was the things happening? One of the things mentioned here, when the sun was coming, facing to the cave, it declined by the will of Allah. So the heat cannot come inside. Morning and afternoon, the heat cannot get penetrate inside the cave. So what happened? The temperature of the cave become minus. It becomes very cold. So they There is no destruction in the body. The body will be like freezer. It will be intact. It will be safe. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and you might think that them awake while they were asleep, and we turn them about to right and to the left. So Allah was by the command to the angels to make them like this and like this. Because if they sleep always like this, they'll get the bed sores in their back, which can be very painful and destructive. So their back was moving, turning, so they will not destroy their back. While their dog outstretching its feet at the entrance. If you look at them, you would certainly turn back from them in flight, and you would certainly be filled with fear above because of them. So when you see these people sleeping and moving like this automatically, and the dog is on the door, you might fear and run away. And thus we raise them that they might question each other. A speaker among them said, how long have you tarried? They said, we have tarried for a day or a part of the day. The other said, your Lord knows best how long you have tarried here. Now send one of you with this silver, one of you this with money of yours to the city. Then let him see which of them has the purest food. So let them bring you provision from it, and let him behave with gentleness, and by no means make your case known to anyone. For surely if they prevail against you, they would stone you to the death or force you to back to their religion, the idol worship religion. And then you will never be successful. And thus did we make to get knowledge of them, that they might know that Allah's promise is true, and that as for the hour, there is no doubt about it, when they disputed among themselves about their affair and said, erect an masjid over them, over that place. Their Lord best knows those who prevail. Erect an edifice above them, a building over them. Their Lord best knows that them. Those who prevailed in them, their affairs said, we will certainly raise a business, we will certainly raise a masjid over them. Over this place, we will make a masjid. They say, there were three, the fourth of them being their dog. And others say, there were five, the sixth of them being their dog, making guess at which is unknown. And the others yet say, seven, and the eighth of them is their dog. Say, my Lord best knows their number. None knows them but a few. Therefore, contend not in the matter of them, but with an outward contention. And do not question concerning them in any of them. And do not say of anything, surely I will do it tomorrow. Illa inshallah. Except say, if Allah will. And remember your Lord when you forget and say, maybe your Lord will guide me to a nearer course, to the right than this. So when there was a time the people came to Prophet Muhammad, they asked three questions. One question about the people of the cave, one question about Zulkarnain, the king, the ruler, and there was one more question. And the Prophet Muhammad said, I will tell you tomorrow. He forget to say inshallah, then he did not get any answer for days from Allah because he did not say inshallah. So if you don't say inshallah, that's very wrong. Don't say, I will do it tomorrow or I will do it later. No, say inshallah. If there is will of Allah, then I can do so. Saying inshallah is a command of Allah. And if something happened, say mashallah, that's happened because of the will of Allah. So inshallah is an obligation. It's farz. It's obligation to say. وَلَبِسُ فِي كَهْفِهِمْ ثَلَاثَةَ مِئَةٍ سِنِينَ وَازْدَادُوا تِسْعًا. They lived in the cave for 300 years, adding 9 years. Why adding 9 years? Before I don't know, but after many years, I knew that. 9 years, if you compute as the solar year, 300 years they lived there. If you compute as the lunar, the moon calendar, 309. And if you can compute that, 300 solar years times 365.5 multiplied by, divided by 354.5 something, then the answer will be accurate. 300 years is equivalent to 300 solar years is equivalent to 309 of moon year, the lunar year. And that's mathematical miracle in the Quran, mentioning the 300 solar years is equivalent to 309 lunar years. And that is because we know, because of the modern science, astronomy, that how many days in the lunar year, which is 354.5 something, and how many days in the solar year is 365 point something. And then this 100% accurate computation in the Quran about the proportion of solar year and the lunar year, how many days each. So 300 solar years is 100% equivalent to 309 lunar years. So every 100 years, how many years will be added? 3. So 100 solar year equivalent to 103 years of lunar calendar. Because lunar calendar is short, 354 days, point something. See, Allah knows best how long they remain to Him. To Him are known the unseen things of the heavens and the earth. How clear His sight and how clear His hearing. There is none to be a guardian for them besides Him. And He does not make anyone His associate in His judgment. And recite what has been revealed to you of the book of your Lord. There is none of one who can alter His words, and you shall not find any refuge besides Him. And withhold yourselves with those who call on their Lord morning and evening, desiring His goodwill, and let not your eyes pass from them, desiring the beauties of this world's life, and do not follow Him whose heart we have made unmindful to our remembrance. And He follows His low desires, and His case is one in which due bounds are exceeded. And say, the truth is from your Lord, so let him who please believe, and let him who please disbelieve. Let him who want to believe, and let him those who want to disbelieve. They have a choice. Surely we have prepared for the iniquitous a fire, the curtains of which shall encompass them about, and if they cry for water, they shall be given water like molten brass, which will scald their faces, evil the drink, and ill the resting place. Except those who believe and do good works, then surely Allah will not waste the reward of those who do a good work. These it is for whom are gardens of perpetuity, beneath which rivers flow. Ornaments shall be given to them therein of bracelets of gold, and they shall wear green robes of fine silk and thick silk brocade interwoven with gold in paradise, reclining therein on raised couches, excellent the recompense and goodly the resting place. And mention to them a parable of two men. For one whom of them who we made two gardens of grape and grapes, and we surround them both with palms, and in midst of them we made cornfields. Both these gardens yielded their fruits and failed not aught thereof, and we caused a river to gush forth in their midst. And he possessed much wealth, so he said to his companion, while he disputed with him, I have greater wealth than you and a mightier in followers. So he made the, what he made? He's making arrogance. He's telling the other one that I have more wealth, more gardens, and more workers working with me. And when he entered in his garden, while he was unjust to himself, he said, I do not think that this will ever perish. So he is also thinking that whatever he has will never finish. And I do not think that hour will come, and he's denying the next life. And even if I am returned to my Lord, I will most certainly find a returning place better than this. His companion was not rich. He said to him while disputing with him, Do you disbelieve in him who created you from the dust, from the soil, then from a small seed, from the sperm, then he made you a perfect man? But as for me, he, Allah, is my Lord, and I do not associate anyone with my Lord. And wherefore did you say not? Did you not say when you entered your garden, MashaAllah, la quwwata illa billah? He said to him, when you entered your garden, why you did not say, MashaAllah, la quwwata illa billah? MashaAllah, la quwwata illa billah. Say that, everybody. MashaAllah, la quwwata illa billah. See, what Allah given us, you must say, MashaAllah, la quwwata illa billah. If not, say, Allah angry, then Allah will send the punishment. So remember, whatever Allah is giving, say, MashaAllah, la quwwata illa billah. For what Allah has given them, say, MashaAllah, la quwwata illa billah, that it is because of the will of Allah, and there is no power except by the will of Allah. There is no power except in Allah. If you say, if you consider me to be inferior to you in wealth and children, then maybe my Lord will give me what is better than your garden and send on it a thunderbolt from the heaven, from the sky, so that it shall become even ground without plant. Or its water should sink down into the ground so that you are unable to find it. And his wealth was destroyed, so he began to wring his hands for what he had spent on it, while it lay having fallen down upon its roofs. And he said, ah, me, would that I had not associated anyone with my Lord. And he had no host to help him besides Allah, nor could he defend himself. Here is protection only from Allah, the true one. He is the best. He is best in reward and best in requiting, in taking the accountability. And set forth to them the parable of the life of this world, like water which we send down from the cloud, so the herbage of the earth becomes tangled on account of it, then it becomes dirty, it becomes dry, broken into pieces, which the winds scatter, and Allah is the holder of power over all the things. Wealth and children are adornment of the life of this world, and the ever-abiding, the good works are better with your Lord in reward and better in expectation. And the day on which we will cause the mountains to pass away, and you will see the earth a leveled plain, and we will gather them and leave not any one of them behind. And they shall be brought before your Lord standing in ranks. Now certainly you have come to us as we have created you at first. Nay, you thought that we had not appointed to your time of the fulfillment of the promise, the day of judgment. And the book shall be placed, then you will see the guilty fearing from what is in it. And they will say, ah, woe to us, what a book is this? It does not omit a small one nor a great one, but numbers them all. And what they had done, they shall find present. And your Lord does not deal unjustly with anyone. That Allah, but for Adam, for his, what Allah is honored to him to make Khalifa on the earth. They made sajda, but Iblis, the shaitan, he did not. He was of the jinn, so he transgressed the commandment of his Lord. What would you then take him and his offspring for friends rather than me? And they are your enemies. Evil is this change for the unjust. So our greatest enemy is Shaitan and his offspring. So Shaitan is not one, but he is like Adam and offspring. We are the offspring of Adam. The Shaitan is the Iblis as offspring. So Allah said that you are going to follow him and not me. It is a worse change. So we should not change to follow Shaitan, but we should follow Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I did not make them witnesses of the creation of the heavens and the earth, nor of the creation of their own souls, nor could I take those who lead astray for the aiders. And certainly we have explained in this Quran every kind of example, and man is most of all given to contention, always fighting, always making debate and argument.